The HP Stream 11 sports an Intel Celeron N2840 2.16 GHz processor with Intel HD graphics, 2GB of DDR L3 RAM, as well as a 32GB embedded multimedia card. And finally, an 11.6 inch anti-glare LED screen with a resolution of 1366 by 768. Now the HP Stream 11 is a very interesting laptop, and I'm excited to welcome you to my review. Hello guys, how are you? David DeFranco here from DavidDeFranco.com. This is my review of the HP Stream 11. And I gotta say right off the bat, what a nice surprise. This thing is packed full of interesting features. But for $200, you have to use it with realistic expectations. So just know that going into this. So starting out my review, let's talk about the pros. First and foremost, the HP Stream 11 is extremely light and portable. I love the idea of simply picking this thing up and going about my business, because I primarily bought myself the HP Stream 11 for the purpose of blogging. Now, while I love being in my office, I love what I do, sometimes it's nice to get away from here and just to relax on the couch, enjoy some movies in the background with Netflix, and just blog using my HP Stream 11. It's just a very convenient experience, and it's something I really appreciate about this small notebook. Now, some people call it laptop, but I prefer the word notebook. Now, this next pro I was not expecting. The keyboard is surprisingly awesome. This is easily one of my favorite features about the HP Stream 11. Seriously, it's that good, especially for a $200 notebook. Okay, so not everybody is a fan of this keyboard design in terms of chiclets, at least that's what some people like to call it, because it is extremely similar to the same keyboard design you would find on a MacBook or MacBook Pro, which in my opinion is a good thing because I'm a huge fan of that design, and the HP Stream 11 definitely does not disappoint in that area. And speaking of not disappointing, I am very happy to say this. The HP Stream 11 is a fanless design. This is my first fanless notebook ever, and I really, really am enjoying it very much. This is coming from someone like me, somebody who was used to using a 17-inch MacBook Pro that would constantly get hot to the touch. Like seriously, it would actually burn my finger if I left it on there for too long. But not only that, the fan noise was always very loud, which kind of distracted me from my work. But that is not the case with the HP Stream 11. Thanks to its fanless design, it's silent. You cannot hear a thing coming out of this notebook. And well, you know what, since I'm praising this thing, let's talk about my next pro, because this is up there with the keyboard design. Battery life. Battery life on the HP Stream 11, it simply kicks ass. 8 hours and 15 minutes is what HP is claiming on their website. And I gotta say, it holds up pretty damn well. I have yet to drain this battery to 0%. That's how good it is. And I've used it for maybe 5 to 6 hours straight at night, just blogging on Brand Rocket, browsing forums, enjoying social media, answering emails. I cannot kill this battery. That is a selling point, in my opinion. So if you're looking for an affordable notebook that can last you the entire day, especially if you're a student, the HP Stream 11 will not disappoint you. And finally, wrapping up my list of pros, this does include 1 terabyte of OneDrive storage. Okay, so if you're not familiar with OneDrive, it's basically Microsoft's solution to cloud storage. So if you're looking to store your photos in the cloud and access them elsewhere, OneDrive is perfect for that. And the same goes for your documents, your movies, and just your files in general. 1 terabyte is a lot of storage, and I'm not even using probably 1 or 2% of that, because I really just use my HP Stream 11 locally for, like I said, blogging and social media and email. But still, I mean, if you're serious about cloud storage, 1 terabyte, that's plenty of space. Okay, so as much as I love the HP Stream 11, of course there's gonna be quite a few drawbacks, because again, $200 for this notebook. I mean, I will say the design is beautiful. It's extremely light, as I've already made clear, and the battery life is simply awesome. But with $200, yeah, you kind of get what you pay for. So let's talk about the cons. The first con, and let me say this right now, this is the most disappointing aspect of this computer, because I am sort of a pixel freak. And well, that's the display. The screen, the quality, the resolution, all that good stuff. Well, it's just that. It's not really good stuff in this case. It's kind of blah, to be honest. The resolution, again, is 1366 by 768, which is not bad at all for a screen size of 11.6 inch. And I gotta say, it is anti-glare, which is definitely very nice. But when it comes down to the overall picture quality, it's not that great. It's actually pretty bad. It makes me think of the days of the iPad 2. And we all know what that was like. Yeah, not that great, especially nowadays since we're spoiled with Retina displays left and right. So moving on to my next con, let's talk about the trackpad. The trackpad is okay. There were some times where it was just unresponsive, where I thought I clicked and the HP Stream 11 did not register that click, but then I would do it again and it would register it just fine. Scrolling is fine. I mean, you can use your two fingers, which works great, but in general, the trackpad could definitely use some work. Now, the notebook does get a little warm because, as I mentioned before, this does have a fanless design, which is just great. I cannot emphasize that enough. I love having a fanless notebook. It's really that awesome. But without a fan, of course, this thing will get a little warm. Now, it never once got nearly as warm as I'm used to with my 17-inch MacBook Pro. Again, that thing would burn my lap, kind of to the point where I would have to take a break, take it off my lap, and be like, woof, I am burning over here. Seriously though, it was that hot, and the HP Stream 11 never once got near that temperature. Now, let me make this clear. It only really gets warm when you're doing intensive things. For instance, I was working on my personal website over at daviddefranco.com, and that uses Squarespace's Layout Engine 2, which is actually quite processor intensive, so that caused my HP Stream 11 to warm up. And speaking of warm, let's talk about performance. Now, I'm gonna repeat myself again. Keep in mind, you're spending $200 on a notebook. So what do you expect? Well, you get what you pay for. Performance is okay. I mean, it's fine for blogging, it's fine for email, it's fine for social media, but when I went to play a YouTube video in full screen, yeah, I mean, I would notice some stuttering here and there, especially on Facebook for some reason. Facebook must do something differently than YouTube does. Because when I play a Facebook video, it lags like hell. But then when I play a YouTube video in non-full screen, it plays just fine. But again, as soon as I go full screen, it might stutter a bit here and there. Okay, so this stuttering was never really to the point where I just wanted to slam this HP Stream 11 against the wall and just be done with it. But I'm just saying, expect subpar performance out of this notebook. Let's talk about the webcam. Yes, this actually has an onboard webcam. I'm not even sure of the resolution because honestly, it doesn't matter because the webcam is terrible. It's a joke. It's unusable. I mean, I've used it once to take my picture for Windows 8.1 and that was it. This thing is not really ideal for Skype, even though HP kind of advertises that. You're better off just connecting an external webcam, which by the way, I don't think I mentioned, this has USB 3.0 on it. So just go that route and you'll most likely be happy. And finally, the last con I want to mention, and please don't get me wrong, I mean, I love this computer, so I don't want people to think I'm hating on it. I bought this with my own money, and I have zero regrets. I'm really enjoying it that much. But I'm always transparent with you guys, so I want to be honest. So the last con is kind of a disappointment because, well, that's the lack of colors. You can get this in Horizon Blue and Orchid Magenta, not black. Now, this is very interesting because some people may argue, well, David, for $200, of course it's gonna have like a childish-like color. Well, that's not entirely true because there are notebooks with similar prices for maybe $200, $220, or even as high as $250 that are black from Asus and I think Acer as well. Which, by the way, I will be exploring their products in the near future. But you know what? That's a whole other video, and I'll save that for another time. But anyway, yes, you only get two color choices, Horizon Blue and Orchid Magenta. Okay, so wrapping up this review, before I get into my final verdict, I want to give you one very important tip that you need to keep in mind if you do decide to purchase this for yourself. Go to Microsoft's online store and buy it from there, because there you are guaranteed to get the signature edition of the HP Stream 11 or the Stream 13. Now this basically means that it includes Office 365 and unlimited OneDrive storage, which is actually kind of a new thing that happened like right after I bought this thing for myself, so that's pretty cool. But the more important reason for stressing the signature edition is this is the clean edition. This is the cleanest possible route you could go with Windows 8.1. If you do not buy the signature edition, then you'll have to deal with bloatware from HP, as well as whatever products and services are included on this laptop from day one. Well, notebook. So take my advice, go to Microsoft's online store. There you can get it for exactly $199. Shipping might actually be free because they upgraded my shipment to expedited shipping. So I basically got this thing overnight, which was amazing. So props to Microsoft. You guys are pretty good. Okay, so the final verdict with the HP Stream 11, excellent notebook for the price, and I have zero regrets. Despite the display kind of being blah and the webcam being, well, blah. Yes, that's my technical term for it sucks. And while overall performance being not that great, I do love this notebook. And for $200, I can definitely recommend it. Especially, again, especially if you're a student or if you're just looking for a cheap alternative. Because for instance, I cannot afford a MacBook Air right now. I just pay too many bills and tax season is coming up. So I was looking into the HP Stream 11 for $200. I mean, I've been more productive than ever at nighttime thanks to this thing. I mean, I can actually sit in front of my TV at nighttime, enjoy movies on Netflix, and get work done in the same time. Whereas I would normally be stuck here in my office, which I really don't mind, but you gotta understand, I'm in here all day as it is, so it's just really nice to pick this thing up, go in my living room, and just enjoy it for what it has to offer. For, again, $200. And if I say $200 one more time, well, I'm gonna have to owe you $200. But seriously guys, the HP Stream 11, $200, definitely look into it. You might be able to get a better deal with a similar notebook from Asus or Acer, because I believe they might be selling a better product with a larger screen and possibly more impressive specs. So with that said, I will be linking you right below to an article on Brand Rocket that actually features 5 notebooks under $200 that are great for blogging on the go. So guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate your support. Let me know what you thought of this review and just comment below. What other notebooks would you like to see me review? Or even cheap tablets? Because I'm definitely considering the HP Stream 7. That's just $99 and I could definitely use a Windows tablet in my life. I mean, I already have one in my living room, that one I did a while back in the summertime, but that's a 10-inch display. I don't know, I mean, just nowadays I prefer a smaller tablet. So I'm very interested in that. But hey, let me know what you think. Thank you again, guys. You're awesome. And I will see you in my next video. Peace.